Welcome, dear students. Today we are going to see how to determine HLB number of surfactant by saponification method. Aim of experiment: to determine HLB number of surfactant by saponification method. Requirements: in requirements, chemicals, distilled water, fatty acid esters, glyceryl monostearate, 0.5 normal alcoholic potassium hydroxide, stearic acid, ether, 0.5 normal hydrochloric acid, 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide, and phenolphthalein indicator. Then apparatus required to perform this experiment: round bottom flask, reflux condenser, beakers, burette, pipette, and conical flask. Hydrophilic lipophilic balance. This was firstly introduced by scientist William Griffey in the late 1940s, and HLB system as a way of figuring out which emulsifier would work best, the oil phase of an emulsified product. It is a relative efficiency of hydrophilic portion of surfactant molecule to its lipophilic portion of same molecule. Means how much hydrophilic groups are there and how much lipophilic groups are there. Based on this, the ratio of these hydrophilic and lipophilic portion on the same molecule is calculated, and HLB number of that particular surfactant is determined. Emulsifier or surfactants are characterized according to the balance between hydrophilic, that is water loving, and lipophilic, that is oil loving portion of their molecules. An emulsifier that is lipophilic in character is assigned a low HLB number, and an emulsifier that is hydrophilic in character is assigned a high number. The midpoint is approximately 10, and the assigned value have ranged from 1 to 40. The hydrophilic lipophilic balance number indicates the polarity of molecules in a range of 1 to 40, with the most commonly used emulsifier having a value between 1 to 20. The HLB number increases with increasing into the hydrophilicity. If your surfactant is having a low number, then it is lipophilic. Lipophilic tail align with oil, hydrophilic head align with water. For most polyhydric alcohol, fatty acid esters, approximate value may be calculated with the help of formula HLB is equal to 20 into bracket 1 minus S upon A, where this S is saponification number and A is acid number of that substance. Then determination of HLB, which is required to use in the formulation. This required HLB is amount of surfactant required to make an oil with remain in a solution, and variation of the proportion of blended emulsifier has been preferred to obtain best results. When two emulsifier of known HLB are thus blended for use with a given oil, there is an optimum ratio that gives best emulsification, and HLB at this ratio is said to be the required HLB of oil. Then formula for the determination of required HLB, that required HLB is equal to W ax hlea plus wbx and hlb b divided by wa plus wb, where this wa is amount of first emulsifier used, that is a, wb amount of second emulsifier b used at the optimum ratio giving best emulsion. Then HLB A and HLB B, these are the assigned HLB values of emulsifier. Means HLB A is the HLB number of your A substance and HLB B is HLB number of B surfactant or substance. HLB oil, that is required HLB for emulsion, these are the values of some surfactants along with their HLB number. Procedure. First step, that is preparation of 0.5 normal alcoholic KOH. Dissolve around 4 gram of KOH in 3 to 5 ml distilled water in a volumetric flask and make up a total volume to 100 ml, allowed to stand for 24 hours, and separate out clear liquid by decantation. So what you have to do, you have to take a 4 gram of KOH, then add up to 3 to 5 ml of distilled water, and then you have to shake it well, and further volume up to 100 ml. This volume you have to make up with ethanol, then your alcoholic KOH is ready to use. You have to keep it aside for the 24 hour and then separate out clear liquid by decantation, and that liquid you have to use for the further experiment. Alcoholic KOH, because surfactants are freely soluble in alcohol than in water, that's why alcoholic KOH is prepared. The solubility improved by alcohol hydrolysis is effective one. Then second step, determination of saponification number of surfactant. For this, you have to take 0.5 gram of GMS and transfer into round bottom flask. Then add 15 ml of alcoholic KOH to it, boiling water bath for about half an hour. Then reflux separately 15 ml of alcoholic potassium hydroxide on a boiling water bath for an hour as a blank. So you require to set two reflux assembly. In first reflux assembly, you have to reflux 0.5 gram of GMS and 15 ml KOH. And in second assembly, just you have to reflux 15 ml alcoholic KOH. So this reading or this second set is considered as the blank set. Cool both the solutions to room temperature and titrate separately against 0.5 normal hydrochloric acid using phenolphthalein as an indicator. So you have to remove this flask and then you have to cool it at room temperature and titrate it against the 0.5 normal hydrochloric acid. Then end point, pink to colorless or slightly yellowish . Then the titer reading for the sample be V1 and blank be as a V2. Means when you titrate only alcoholic KOH against HCl, then it will be your V2 reading. And when you are titrating KOH plus GMS, then this will be your V1 reading. Then third part, that is determination of acid number. you have to take 0.5 gram of stearic acid, add it to a mixture of 10 ml of alcohol and 10 ml of ether. If stearic acid does not dissolve, warm it on a water bath until it dissolves. But during heating, you have to take care because both ether and alcohols are highly inflammable liquids. Titrate solution of stearic acid against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide using phenolphthalein as an indicator. Then this reading will be your V3 reading.
Now I am determining acid number of given surfactants. So for these acid number determination, I require stearic acid, alcohol, ether, then 0.1 normal NaOH and phenolphthalein. Here I have taken 0.5 gram of stearic acid. Then I am going to add this 10 ml alcohol in this beaker. Then I'm adding this ether into the same beaker. It's solubilized into these ether and alcohol. Now we'll titrate it. Now I'm transferring it into the conical flask. Then I'll add phenolphthalein and titrate against the NaOH. Slowly you have to add this phenol NaOH, and when your solution into this conical converted into the pink color, then you have to stop this with your end point. Now my colorless solution is converted into the pink color. We have finished with the titration and this is end point of the titration. I am going to determine SAP value of the surfactant. Now first of all, I am taking 15 ml of this alcoholic KOH. Now how to prepare this alcoholic KOH? You have to take 4 gram of KOH into 3 ml of water. Then we have to make up a volume up to 100 ml with help of ethanol. this will be your alcoholic cure. Now you allow to keep it for 24 hours and then you have to use the supernet. Now I am typing this alcoholic KOH into the round bottom flask and it is labeled as alcoholic KOH. Now in this second round bottom flask, you require to take glycerin monostearate and 15 ml alcoholic KOH. Now here I have to weigh this glycerin monostearate. So I am going to add it into this round bottom flask and same volume of KOH, that is 15 ml, I am adding into this GOS. Now what you have to do, both of these round bottom flasks you have to put for the reflux. Now I reflux it. To this condenser I have fitted round bottom flask with only alcoholic KOH and for the second condenser I have fitted this round bottom flask consists of GMS plus alcoholic KOH. Likewise you have to reflux it for 1 hour and then you have to remove this round bottom flask. Completion of reflux process, I have separated out these two round bottom flasks from condenser and I am titrating it against 0.5 normal HCl by using phenolphthalein as an index. When you add this phenolphthalein, it shows pink color. And when you titrate it against the HCl, this pink color will disappear. When this pink color disappears, at that time you have to note down the burette rate. Add the glycerin into this solution. Now it is colorless. Now this is end point of titration. Now I am titrating this solution from second round bottom flask, which consists of GMS and alcoholic KOH. Few more amount of phenolphthalein. sulfonin is required because initially it should be converted into the pink color. Now color of solution is pink. Now we titrate it against HCl and endpoint H. When the solution is converted into the colorless solution, initially it is pink color when you add the spin off to it. Pink color is disappear. Note down the unit reading and proceed for the calculation.
Observations. Saponification number. Volume of 0.5 normal HCl consumed by sample. Sample means GMS plus KOH, alcoholic KOH. So observed burette reading is 2.5 ml. Then volume of 0.5 normal HCl consumed by blank. Blank means only alcoholic KOH we have taken for the reflux, and reading obtained from that 15 ml alcoholic KOH is 4 ml. Then acid number, volume of 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide consumed by stearic acid, and that is 17.5 ml. Then calculations, calculation of saponification number, 1000 ml of 1 normal KOH is equal to 56,000 milligram of KOH. So V2 minus V1 ml of 0.5 normal KOH is equal to 56,000 divided by 1000 milligram of KOH per gram of GMS. Then after putting values of this V2 and V1 into this equation, we'll get value 84 milligram of KOH is required for per gram of your GMS. So saponification number of given surfactant is 84. Then second part we require to calculate, that is acid number. V3 ml of 0.1 normal NaOH is equal to 0.5 gram of stearic acid. So for the simplification purpose, you have to convert this 0.5 into 1. So required to multiply it by 2. Then similarly, we require to multiply by 2 to our burette reading, that is V3. Factor 1000 ml of NaOH is equal to 1000 ml of 1 normal KOH is equal to 56,000 milligram of KOH. So 2 V3 ml of 0.1 normal KOH is equal to 56,000 divided by 1000 into 0.1 into 17.5. So 0 get cancelled. So it will become 56 into 0.1 into 2 into 17.5 is our burette reading. And final answer is 196. So acid number is 196. Now we'll see our final calculation for HLB value. The formula for the HLB number is HLB is equal to 20 into bracket 1 minus S upon A, where this S value is saponification number and A value is acid number. So we have our value of sap and acid number with us. So 20 into bracket 1 minus 84 divided by 196. After solving this, observed value of HRB value of given surfactant is 11.42. Then the result, the HLB value of given surfactant was found to be 11.42. Now we'll move towards the synopsis viva questions. First question, what are surfactants? Surfactants are a compound that lower a surface tension or interfacial tension between two liquids, between gas and liquid, or between liquid solid. Surfactant may act as a detergent, wetting agent, emulsifier, then foaming agent and dispersant. Second question, classification of surfactants. Surfactants are classified based on charge present on head of your monomer. A non-ionic surfactant do not have any charge group over its head, and head of an ionic surfactant carries a net charge. And if charge is negative, then surfactant is more specifically anionic surfactant. And if charge is positive, then it is called as cationic surfactant. And if head part of monomer of surfactant having both charges, positive as well as negative, then it is termed as the Zwitter ion. So these surfactants are classified into four subclasses, that is anionic surfactant having a negative charge on head part, cationic surfactant carries positive charge on head, then non-ionic, no charge is there on head part of surfactant or monomer, and last one is amphoteric or zwitterionic. In these type of the surfactant, head part of monomer carries both the charges, positive as well as negative. Then third question, what are the properties of surfactants? Wetting of solid, then solubilization, emulsification, dispersion of solid into the solution, then micellization, and detergencies. So these are the different properties of surfactants. Then next question, why surfactant named as amphiphiles? Because a monomer of surfactant, it has a characteristic structure and it possesses both hydrophobic group, that is non-polar region at tail part, and it usually contains C12 to C18 hydrocarbon chain and hydrophilic group or polar region present on head of your monomer of surfactant. Therefore, they are solubilized both into the organic as well as aqueous solvent. That's why surfactants are named as amphiphiles. What is HLB scale range? So this is HLB scale range from 0 to 18. Anti-foaming agents having a range 2 to 3. Then emulsifying agent used for the WYO type of emulsion 3 to 6. Then wetting agent and spreading agent 7 to 9. Then again, emulsifying agent used into the O by W type of the emulsion, 8 to 16. Then detergent is having HLB number 13 to 15. And solubilizing agent having HLB number 15 to 18. Then what are wetting agents? Wetting agents are substances that reduces surface tension of water to allow it to spread a drop onto a surface and increasing a spreading ability of your liquid. Then what is acid value? Acid value is defined as amount of KOH needed in milligrams to neutralize the organic acid which is present in a 1 gram of fat. It is used to measure a free fatty acid that are present in the fat or oil. Then what is saponification value? Saponification value is defined as the amount of KOH required in milligram to turn 1 gram of fat into soap. It depends on nature of fatty acid that are contained in the fat. So this is all about determination of HLB number. Thank you.